What up, Doc?
In this episode of the Big Urban Myth Show, if you do this, will you fail this? Will turning on these lights lead to turning out your lights? Do big feet mean big meat? And the truth about Shakira, suckers, toilets, tabloids, frogs, and freaks.
Hey guys, I'm Alyson Hannigan, and welcome to MTV's Big Urban Myth Show. Ever hear the one about Britney Spears? You know that one. Or the candy that explodes in your stomach? All the money you're gonna get if you forward this email to 10 different people? Most of that stuff's a bunch of bunk. They're urban myths, but lots of people bought them when they read them on the internet. That's the challenge we face on this show. We'll dig through the truckloads of myths out there and separate the stuff that really happened from the stuff we like to believe really happened. Sit tight, it's MTV's Big Urban Myth Show.
An urban myth out there. Sitcoms have joked about it, movies have alluded to it, and newspapers have written about it. We're talking about the urban myth that says eat a poppy seed bagel and it will show up as heroin on a drug test. Sky and Dave were tested earlier this morning and were confirmed clean and sober. So then we took them to another drug testing facility to bunk or debunk this myth. Before the test that morning, Sky ate a poppy seed bagel. Dave did not. The drug tester had no idea that Sky had eaten a poppy seed bagel.
Now, we're going to test for five different drugs today. Marijuana, cocaine, PCP, morphine, which includes heroin, and methamphetamine, which includes ecstasy.
Here, let me show you where the rest of it is.
Okay.
The way it works is, if there's a line next to the name of the drug, that means it's a negative. If there's no line, it would mean a positive. All right, congratulations, Dave. It's a negative test. Okay, Scott, it's your turn. At this point, I would have to declare it's a positive.
The test shows that I've done some sort of opiate or morphine-related drug, like heroin.
Sky asked if it could be the poppy seeds, but she was told, no way in heck.
How many bagels
are we need like truckload, probably.
Truckload of bagels?
It looked like the scientists had been duped and we'd proven the urban myth about poppy seeds true. Is it true that urban street gangs are killing unsuspecting motorists in a blood initiation weekend known as Lights Out?
I've heard urban legends about gang members doing that. You flash them, they chase you down.
Like around the valley, they say that people actually do drive around and do that. It's like a little gang.
The myth is considerate motorists will often use a courtesy flash to let a driver know their headlights are out. But could flashing your lights lead to your life flashing before your eyes?
Get him!
Sergeant Jay Moroso is a narcotics supervisor with the Santa Monica Police Department.
I don't know where this myth came from, but within the last few years, we've been getting several phone calls about it.
Alejandro Alonso has written numerous pieces about gangs and runs a website, streetgangs.com.
There's completely different types of initiation things that take place, and the headlight controversy turned out to be pure urban legend.
One of the real reasons why somebody would flash their lights at you is maybe if they were to indicate that a radar trap was up ahead.
No, I don't think it's true.
I've never heard of it happening before.
If you're not knowledgeable on it, then you can believe anything.
Sorry, but we gotta snuff the life out of this myth. We're tagging a big fat false across this legend and letting drivers know it's okay to give headlight props to your fellow motorists.
Lesson learned. Don't be afraid to flip off your fellow motorists. Well, you know what I mean. Now get ready to be significantly freaked out by this next nasty myth.
For all of you who like to lead a clean lifestyle, this next myth will leave you with dirty thoughts. Not that kind. We're talking toilets, people. The myth purports that without paper placed on the seat, your ass is open house for millions of different germs.
Ew!
Oh, I would never just sit on the toilet.
I put the little thingy down.
Just all the germs on there.
Oh, dude!
Is it true the public toilets that play host to literally hundreds of asses are actually germ central? Or is it all just a bunch of crap?
You can get all kinds of nasty diseases from a toilet seat.
Like stuff that just turns your ass into a big red mess.
Herpes can live on a toilet seat for over an hour.
Hi, I'm Sheila. I'm a lab tech from 100 UCLA Plaza Lab, and we're going to be taking a swab from the toilet seat to check for bacterial germs.
So we swabbed this toilet at a popular college bar, as well as a number of other surfaces common in college life. And then the vials of goop are brought to Charlene Wise at 100 Plaza Labs at UCLA. There, they work their microbial magic. The results may shock you and make you question your common sense.
No, it's not messy. The toilets are dirty.
Wrong. There proved to be more nastiness in an Eminem lyric than on a toilet seat. Even though hundreds of people use it, the test showed no major germs.
The surfaces that probably carry more germs would be cell phones, doorknobs, car keys, and especially money.
What kind of germs, you ask? Try our buddy Staphylococcus aureus and his homie E. coli.
Those organisms can be very virulent.
Virulent, as in messed up, badass nastiness. So as for the toilet seat being the number one home to germs, that myth is false. True or false, toad licking will get you high? We'll answer that in a minute. And
when we come back, party in your mouth. Disney and Deep Freeze and Shakira's shocking virtual vandalism. True or false, you'll see.
So did you figure it out? Is toad licking a good way to get high?
I have no idea. I've never licked a toad.
Well, here's the deal. There is one toad out of hundreds of varieties that makes a toxin called bufotene that can be hallucinogenic. The problem is, the stuff on the toad's skin is venom. So licking it will probably cause major organ failure and could include death.
I don't know, I was about to try it either.
Sorry, there's no prince when you kiss this frog. Toad licking ain't nothing but false and very disgusting, slimy, green myth.
Welcome back to MTV's Big Urban Myth Show. You remember someone telling you that there were alligators in the sewers? That's some serious old school mythology. Coming up, we're gonna check out another classic, but first some new school stuff.
Open wide for this myth. We got a surprise for your mouth. It's called a wintergreen lifesaver. And the word on the street is, you crack this mother open, and you're gonna get a lightning bolt in your pie hole.
No.
That's not true.
When you bite them in the dark, they spark.
I know it's not true, but...
Well, guess what, all you naysayers? We've got some information for you. The answer to the lifesaver mystery lies in a research article written by Professor Linda Sweeting of Towson University. They claim the myth might not be so far-fetched. Here's how they explain it. The wintergreen lifesavers are triboluminescent. If you want to get technical, fractaluminescent. Smashing the candy's asymmetric crystalline structure creates regions of opposite charge on either side of the crack. Oh, forget it. Look. Say these are giant sugar molecules. They're kind of jagged, so when they get forcefully broken apart by a hammer or your teeth, they emit a charge like miniature lightning. The spark is teeny, teeny, tiny, but if you look close, you can see it. So go ahead and light up your big mouth. We're giving this electrifying myth a very energetic true. This next myth is a triple threat. We're looking at three stories rocking the music scene. Is Shakira making it hard to get your hard drive turned on? Believe it or not, the Latin rum shaker is breaking hearts and crashing computers across the land. Okay, not Shakira herself, but a pirate who bogarted the temptress's name. The myth says that if you open an email that claims to have pictures of Shakira, you're gonna get a worm launched into your system and everyone in your address book. And then your computer will crash. We looked into the cyber myth and found out it's true. So dump any emails that seem too good to be true or risk the wrath of Shakira. By the way, the Colombian love goddess ain't got nothing to do with the vicious virus. Okay, we're not ones to gossip, but the myth claims that the white stripes have been yanking your chain. They've been telling everybody that they're brother and sister, but in fact, the myth says they're really ex-husband and wife. Why did the stripes think they could dupe us? Maybe it's because the duo look alike. Or maybe it's because Jack introduces Meg on stage as his sister. Well, let the facts speak for themselves. Well, we found a marriage license in Detroit, the band's hometown. Turns out that in 96, Jack White, known as John Gillis, married Megan White. And for reasons unknown, decided to take Meg's surname. In 2001, the Peppermint Duo decided to end their five-year marriage, but continued to keep the band together. Sorry, no freaky Jerry Springer story here, but the myth is true. Michael Jackson is in a category by himself in a lot of ways, but this urban legend would put him in his own area code. The story is that MJ hid his phone number in the barcode of his immensely successful Thriller album. We decided to do a test to see if the mic man was passing digits on his vinyl. We call the phone number, and this is what we got.
We're sorry. Your call did not go through.
The area code 746, it doesn't even exist. So don't get hung up on this false myth.
If you make it to a certain level in life, people start talking about you. Just think of all the stories you've heard about Michael Jackson, Britney Spears, NSYNC, and Nirvana. Well, this next guy is one of the granddaddies of them all.
You ever hear the one about the eccentric theme park visionary Walt Disney?
I heard Walt Disney froze himself.
Walt had the imagination to invent a cool theme park that left people in awe. So could this very same eccentric mind have dreamed about visiting the future through deep freeze?
I heard that Walt Disney, like, chopped his head and froze it somewhere.
The rumor is that the Dizman probably thought he could be thawed out in the future, have his body regenerated, and be back in business in, say, 2050 or so. To bring this myth down to room temperature, we scoped out the people who know what it means to have a cold heart.
We are the world's largest cryonics organization. Once you have been declared dead, Alcor comes and will preserve you here in a state of vitrification, hopefully to be reanimated and be brought back to life probably 50 years from now.
That's right, baby. We're talking cryonics. And the top place in the nation to freeze your dead, lifeless body is here at Alcor in Scottsdale, Arizona. Could old Walt have been one of the first to go polar after his death, have his body drop down to a preservation temperature of minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit? Alcor's marketing director, Carla Johnson, best sums up why this myth emerged to begin with.
I really wanted to believe that maybe he was here. He's still able to reach the child in all of us.
He publicly went on television and expressed a desire that he might want to have this happen.
I have heard something about Walt Disney deciding to freeze himself after he was dead.
I wish I could say that. I wish it were true.
Unfortunately, the very first cryonaut was put into the old deep freeze in January of 67. Disney died a month before that. Oops, talk about your bad timing.
If you need your proof on Mr. Disney, visit the family cemetery that has his ashes.
So we did. It's hard to find, but if you wind through some archways, pass a couple of gates, and push aside some leafy greens, you'll find it there. The crypt with Walt's name on it. Yep, between fire and ice, old Walt chose cremation. But you have to admit, it does ignite the imagination.
If anybody deserved to be reanimated, as it were, it's Walt Disney, because he was the king of animation.
You can put this myth on ice. We're calling it false. True or false, if you fold a $20 bill, you can see an eerie image of the events of 9/11. And if it's true, why is it there? We'll answer that in a minute. And
when we return, Tupac tells all, get out your rulers, guys, and you can stick this myth where it counts.
Urban myth holds that if you fold one of the new $20 bills a certain way, you can see an image of the Twin Towers burning.
I actually saw it. If you fold the $20 bill a certain way, that it would show the World Trade Center being blown up.
Somebody said the American government knew, but the American government knew, why would they want to give us clues about it?
We contacted the U.S. Treasury Department to find out. Their only comment was, the money was designed in 1996.
Kind of weird.
Just coincidence, I guess.
I personally don't buy into any of this.
Sorry, no conspiracy here. Anyone who's mastered origami could virtually fold anything into a vision of doom. This myth is sad, but true.
Hey guys, welcome back. Remember Goodwill Hunting when some kid solves an impossible math problem? Well, that was based on an urban myth, and it really happened. Yep,
true.
And just recently in Punch Drunk Love, when Adam Sandler's character buys pudding to get free airline miles, also based on urban myth, also true. Hey, not all myths are bunk. See if you can swallow this next batch of tall tales.
This innocent-looking bottle of pop may seem like the cure-all to a heavy thirst. But as legend goes, it may have a more subverted purpose. They say this crude technique might be a quick fix type of birth control. Are they crazy, or is it true?
Ready to do it.
I heard in a movie one time, this girl got pregnant and her friends were saying, if you shake up a bottle of some carbonated drink and you put it up there while it's still fizzy, it could prevent pregnancy.
The legend goes that after a night of unprotected sex, a woman shakes up a bottle of cola and introduces it into her vagina in the hopes of preventing pregnancy. The belief is that any liquid strong enough to clean a penny can certainly kill sperm.
I've heard that if you do it in water, then it's like not possible to get pregnant.
I've heard that if you have sex when you're standing up, you won't get pregnant.
You can't get pregnant when you're on your period.
With so many misconceptions out there, we needed our Sherpa guide through the Rocky Mountains of sex miseducation to get to the bottom of our cola scandal. Meet Dr. Cheryl Ross, the voice of reason in the midst of this carbonated chaos.
I've heard of douching with other things. I've heard of douching with tequila, and I've also just heard of douching with vinegar. Completely not effective as birth control.
And as for soda gate,
let me remind you all that it is a myth. I am completely unaware of studies that support douching with cola as being effective. And I'm sure that it would probably cause some wicked yeast infections.
Douching in general is gross.
Lesson learned. Sorry, but you'll find that most real birth control products don't come in diet or caffeine-free form. This myth is false. Is it true that the prolific rapper Tupac Shakur foresaw his future? Is there a message hidden in the beginning of his posthumous album Machiavelli? And does that message suggest, as the myth alleges, that death row kingpin Suge Knight would be the one to assassinate Tupac? Will you be the judge? Listen to it again.
It does sound like it says Suge shot me.
Like you hear it right before, like you hear a demon adult.
Yeah, it said Suge shot me, like, very faintly in the beginning of that.
It does definitely sound like Suge shot me.
Yeah, that's really weird.
Illuminati. We decided to go CSI on this myth and took our vinyl to one of the leading forensic audio experts in the nation, Anthony Pelicano. Anthony defended both Judas Priest and Ozzy when angry parents claimed hidden messages in the artist's songs led to their kid's suicide. Anthony proved there were no hidden messages. He has a keen ear for the truth and did a thorough autopsy on our Tupac myth.
You always listen for what someone suggested to you.
Anthony is careful not to make mistakes. In law enforcement, his opinion can lead to arrests and jail sentences.
With this particular recording, because of the suggestion, it's possible to hear Suge shot me, but it's not actually what's being said.
So what does the track say?
I hear something like gonna stop me, or something stop me, or it could even be something like from the top.
Like so many myths with Tupac, we believe it because we want to believe it.
There's definitely hidden messages in Tupac's music. Like he started calling himself Machiavelli, who faked his own death.
Many of the mysteries about Tupac remain unsolved. The answer to this one myth is loud and clear: false. This next myth is for those of you who measure a man not by the depth of his soul, but by the length of his pipe. We're talking about the age-old legend that guys with big feet must have big meat. Is it possibly true that you can tell if a guy is packing a pickle or a carrot simply by observing the length of his Skechers? To answer the question, we went to speak with an expert who knows a thing or two about the penis. All right, there we said it. Dr. Alan Shapiro is a prominent urologist and has been looking at penises for over 30 years.
There's a tremendous amount of myths. A larger flaccid penis might not be as large as you would expect it to be erect.
With no official medical studies done on shooted genital size, we would only be guessing.
There are some myths about correlation of shoe size and size of penis.
So we decided to go scientific on this myth. We found four guys willing to have their Peters metered.
I can't wait.
On national TV. Meet 9.5, 10.5, 11, and 11.5.
We're going to see if there's a correlation. I'm going to examine a number of men. The urologist doesn't usually get to see the penis erect. Let's say it's not truly scientific.
The doc agreed to set aside strict medical ethics to help settle this old locker room lore.
I'm going to go inside and verify this erection. He's working on it. How are we doing? Attaboy. Attaboy. This gentleman with an 11 and a half shoe size had a 6-inch erection. Okay, John. This gentleman with a 9.5 shoe size at 5 3/4. This gentleman has a 10.5 shoe size, and the erect penis was 6.5 inches. This gentleman with an 11 shoe size has a 7-inch erection.
For those of you keeping score at home, just take our word for it. If you're a size snob, well, there's no glass slipper ending to this fairy tale. Sorry, but the numbers don't lie.
My impression after having seen many penises is that there probably is little correlation.
Four very happy test subjects later, one very amused urologist. It's safe to say the feet-to-penis myth is false. But if you want to judge a book by its cover, don't give up all hope.
I think there's more correlation with width of fingers and width of penis than actual length.
That ought to make your next handshake pretty entertaining.
So you still believe there are alligators in the sewers? Think Bill Gates is going to send you money if you forward his email? Think a certain brand of beer is made with urine? Then you got to get out more often. But that's the whole point of urban myths. Sometimes they sound so good you just can't tell. We suggest you think twice about something you read on the internet. Something too good to be true usually isn't. But then again, fact is always stranger than fiction. You never know. I'm Alyson Hannigan for MTV's Big Urban Myth Show. Bye.
Speakers are pumping, still jumping.